briefly, and as we've been looking at the topic of divine boundaries, and that is the theme that we've been having, you know, the divine boundaries, walking into those divine boundaries. And our main text has been Acts. Just to recap, for them who are joining us maybe for the first time, is Acts 17. Acts chapter 17, verse 26 and 27 has been our theme. Ama hii ndio imekuwa ikituongoza. Acts 17, verse 26 and 27. And I'll read it in the name of Jesus. Acts 17, 26. From one man, God made everything else. He made every nation of men that they should inhabit the whole earth. And he determined the time set for them and the exact places where they should live. So there are three things that we've been seeing. That God created us from Adam. From one man, he created every person, every man that you can see, from every nation. It is God who determined us to be where we are. That is why we were not born as Chinese, we were born as Kenyans. That is why nobody chooses which tribe to be born. And that's why we come against the spirit of tribalism in Jesus' name. Because God created us the way we are, from where we are, in our families, in his own divine wisdom. Praise God. From one man, he created all other men. Praise God. Every nation of men. Why? He created us. Number two, so that we may inhabit, we may dwell, we may have dominion, we may reign. Praise God. The reason that's why man has been given such a mind that above all the other animals is so that we can have dominion, so that we can think. Praise God. And then he determined the time set for them. He has determined the time. He has set the time for each and every one of us. That is why we come into this world when we are born and we exit. And in between is what we call time. And God gives us time. And that's why the Bible says we redeem the time because the days are evil. Sindio? Tukomboe wakati kwa sababu nyakati, they are evil. And then number the last one is he gave us boundaries. And these are boundaries that God has given us. Kuna mipanka ambayo ni ya kiungu ambayo Mungu ametupa. They are divine boundaries that God has set for us. And this is the verse that we've been looking at. And today we just want to look at the topic of reigning within our boundaries. How will we dominate within those boundaries that God has given us? Because God will give you boundaries. By the time you come into this world and the time you exit, there are boundaries that God has designed you to be. And life is very interesting because life is like an onion. And God reveals one layer at a time. Because the walk and the journey to our destiny is progressive. Njia yetu ama barabara yetu ya kwenda mpaka pale Mungu ametupangia ni barabara ambayo tunaenda step by step. God reveals a step by step. That is why even in life, when kids come to school, they go to standard one. After they finish standard one, they go to the next level. Then they go to the next level. Because life is progressive. And the destiny that God has given unto us is very progressive. Because if God was to reveal what he was to do in your life, it will be so much. Praise God. Because the Bible says in Jeremiah that he has a good plan for each and every one of us. And so one of the things, today we'll be talking about three points. How do we reign? How do we dominate? Just like what we have seen in Acts 17:26. How do we dominate these boundaries? Sisi tutatawaraje katika hizi mipaka ambayo ni ya kiungu ambayo Mungu ametupea? As a mother, as a father, how will you dominate within the life and the children that God has given you? Because you are a steward for the children, for the education, for the business, for the wealth that God has given unto you. For this bread that right now you have, you are a steward. And the issue is, how do you dominate? How do you reign? How do you protect? Because we'll be seeing that they are enemies of these boundaries. So number one is we need to allow the administration of God's grace into our lives. If you're writing, you can write that. Allow the administration of God's grace in your life. You have to allow the grace of God. Because ni kwa sababu ya neema, it's because of the grace of God that we are born again. Praise God. It's by the grace of God that you are who you are. If you look back at your life, you can see the grace of God working in your life. If you see where God has brought you from, and he has brought you step by step, By the time you went to school, some of us went to school, there were no shoes. Some of us went to school, there was no food. Some of us had to walk very long distances to go to school. Some of us, there was no school fees, but God provided from grace to grace. God has been so good and gracious to us. No wonder the song says, amazing grace, praise God. Oh, how good the amazing grace of God. But now, the grace of God is available to each and every one of us. But not everybody allows the grace of God to work in their lives. And it is very sad that God has been so gracious to so many people. God has protected so many people. God has given so many people lives and finances and health, divine protection and a family and everything. And the grace of God, just as we'll be talking, because the grace of God is multifaced. It has many faces. The grace of God, it has many ways and many values, but many people do not allow the administration of the grace of God in life. So one of the ways that you need to go to the extent of your divine boundaries is to allow the administration of the grace of God. Na neno moja ambayo unaweza tusaidia ni Ephesians 3. Ephesians 3 were from verse 2 to 3. And we read Ephesians 3, 2 to 3. This is Paul. Paul was one man who understood about the grace of God. No wonder in every letter he starts with the grace of God and he ends with the grace of God. Because he could understand. And he said, it's by the grace of God. I was the least of all the disciples, the apostles. But because of the grace of God, I am the one that God revealed so much. In this word of God, two-thirds of the New Testament was written by Paul. And Paul says in chapter 3 of Ephesians, it is because of the grace of God that he has revealed unto me and he has brought so much understanding. No wonder Paul wrote everything about the church. Paul is the one who understood the manifold wisdom of God in the church. Yeye ndiye alijua hatima ya kanisa. Na akajua ni kwa nini kanisa iliundwa niweze kuleta utawala wa Mungu katika mataifa. Paul is the one who could understand about the Lord's table. He says, from what I received from the Lord, I give unto you. Paul understood about the grace of God. And because of the grace of God, he was able to live to his maximum. And the only way you can live to your maximum is you allow the grace of God. Sasa sijui kama siku ya leo, una allow the grace, the administration of the grace of God. And Paul says in Ephesians 3, 2 to 3, surely, I read, surely you have heard about the administration of God's grace that was given to me for you. Paul recognized the grace of God. Oh, how I pray today that you recognize the grace of God that is working in you. That is by the grace of God you are born again. It is by the grace of God you have life right now. It's by the grace of God you are not in a hospital somewhere. It's by the grace of God you have a family and you came from a house. It's by the grace of God that you have the freedom. It's by the grace of God that you have children, you have a family. It's by the grace of God this church stands here. It's by the grace of God you can see Pastor Livingstone standing here. When I know where God has brought me from. It's by the grace of God we're able to stand with this church. Even when there was coronavirus and we're able to stand with this church. It's by the grace of God this church will be full of people. It's by the grace of God many will be born again in this sanctuary. It's by the grace of God many destinies of many people will be changed. It's by the grace of God that the nation of Kenya stands. It's by the grace of God that the earth goes round. Praise God. It is by the grace of God. It is very sad. Many people do not appreciate the grace of God. Many people even don't have time even to go to church, even to worship God. And he has been so gracious unto them. But Paul understood and he said, you have heard about the administration. The word administration means what? The process or activity of managing. Are you managing the grace of God in your life? It's day to day. Every day ukiamka asubuhi unainua mkono unasema, thank you Father for the grace of God for this day. Every day has new graces. Praise God. And that's why the Bible says, be multiplied. Grace can be multiplied. Grace can grow. From grace to grace. From glory to glory. Hallelujah. So you need to administer the grace of God in your life so that you can go to the extent of your boundaries. Mpaka ufike pale Mungu amekupangia mpaka you allow the grace of God. And Paul says, that grace of God that was given to me, that is the mystery known to me by revelation, as I have to you. so that in all times, having that you need, you will abound in every good work. That God is able to make all grace abound, increase in your life. Praise God. We are talking about administration. When you recognize about the administration of the grace of God, and God is able, God is not limited. He is able to make all grace abound in you or abound in you. Why? So that in all things, katika kila kitu, in your business, in your family, in your spirituality, in your work, in every area, having all that you need, you will get all you need in every area of your life. And you'll be able to abound in every good work. So the grace of God is available for each and every one of us. If the grace of God is for you to be a business person, the grace of God is available. It's for you for a ministry, the grace of God is available. For being a mom, for those children and your family, the grace of God is available. For each and every one of us, praise God. And God has given you freely that grace. But you need to understand and to recognize and start utilizing that grace. And I want to talk here. The other time we mentioned about the different types of graces. There is the saving grace. The saving grace is the one that saves us. Praise God. There is the sanctifying grace. When you become born again, maybe somebody was smoking or whatever other things. It's the sanctifying grace that helps somebody live a Christian life. So even for that person who's watching and you're struggling, you've given your life to Jesus, but there are the issues that you're struggling. I decree the sanctifying grace of God into you. That God will sanctify you and give you strength to overcome sin and overcome the oppressions of the enemy. The grace of God is available for you to stand until you affirm as a Christian in Jesus' name. There's a grace of fruitfulness. There's a grace of increase. I decree the grace of increase for you in Jesus' name. Even the remaining part of 2020, I speak increasing grace, increasing fruitfulness. You shall be fruitful in your business, in your home, as a father, as a mother. Even this church will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Even the nation of Kenya will be fruitful. There is a grace of the assignment and the mandate that God has given you. Everybody has a calling of God, and the grace of God is available. There is security grace in Jesus' name. Even from coronavirus and COVID and any other thing, I declare the grace of God. The securing grace of God. Hallelujah. The grace of prosperity to prosper you. That grace, 2 Corinthians 9:8, God is able to abide all these types of graces. They are available for you. So that any time, with all that you need, you may abound in every good work. You grow in the good work. Being a father, being a mother, being a business person, being a person who is employed wherever you are, you will abound in increase. Praise God. The grace of a builder like Nehemiah. Nehemiah was able to build even under difficult circumstances. Even the grace of God has given us to build this temple in Jesus' name. That is the grace of God that has enabled us, this church, to be the way it is. This is the grace of favor that breaks the spirit of rejection. I declare there will be no spirit of rejection in your life. In the name of Jesus. People will be coming to bless you and to give you into your bosom. In the name of Jesus. That is a grace of acceptability. You have the grace of being heard. Like this church has the grace of being heard in this area and being accepted. That is the grace of God. There is a grace of speed. That your things will go very fast in Jesus' name. I decree the last part of 2020, you will move in the high speed. You will grow in speed in Jesus' name. If you're in school, you'll grow in speed. You will finish your academic years very fast in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I receive the grace of God. Everybody say, I receive the grace of God. When you receive the grace of God and the administration of the grace of God, you allow the administration and the work of the grace of God, then you will be able to extend to the boundaries that God has given unto you. That is point number one. We are talking about how you can, you know, get into your areas and reign, have dominion over the boundaries that God has given unto us. Point number two, in your writing, you need to get an insight of your divine boundaries. Mpaka ujue na macho yako ya ndani ya kiroho, ujue hiyo mipaka ambayo Mungu amekupea. You need to get an insight. And Paul talks about in Ephesians 3 that we talked from verse 3. He talked about the grace of God. You know about the administration of the grace of God that was given unto me. And then from verse 4 he continues. And he says, in reading this then you'll be able to understand my insight into the mystery. For you to get the insight of your life. For you to understand the purposes of God in your life. Because the insight is what gives the person the understanding of the purpose of their life. And Paul understood the insight, number one, because of allowing the grace of God. If you allow the grace of God to work in your life, number two, you will get an insight. Insight means what? A sight that is within. One of the things that you see Jesus did, he healed many blind men. Why did Jesus heal so many blind men than any other person? Because sight is very important. Praise God. One of the men he healed was John chapter 9. If you read the whole of John chapter 9, the man, he put some mud in his eyes and he told him, go and wash in the pool of Siloam, so that you can go and watch. Jesus wanted him to come from the familiar area. Many times we do not see the insight and the things that God has put in us because we are used in a certain territory. When you are used in a certain territory, you are brought up in a poor background. You think like a poor, you know, that mentality has bogged you down. You think in a certain way. It rivets you to go to the boundaries that God wants you to go. Praise God. And that's why you have to break and you have to get a revelation of the insight to understand what is the purpose of God. There are three types of sights I want just to mention. Number one is hindsight. What used to happen? H-I-N-D. Hindsight. Then there is insight. And then there is foresight. What will happen? And Paul is demonstrating in Ephesians 3, 4 to 6. And he talks about his life. And he says, you know how I used to persecute the church? That is hindsight. What was behind? We can know and look back what we used to be and how we used to think. And he says, but now when I received Jesus, when he came and brought me down, and he blinded me. Do you know why Jesus brought Paul down and blinded him for 3 days? So that his physical eyes could be shut. And then he can open his inner eyes. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. How I pray that your inner eyes will be alight. Amen. How I pray it's better you have the insight other than this sight. And Jesus had to break his sight to close his eyes. So that Paul could see insight. And that is why for 3 days, Paul got a revelation and he understood who he was. And he understood that he used to persecute the church. And now he realized who is the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. And he said, from now, my life, I count back anything like done. But I pursue so that I may receive what is ahead of me. Hallelujah. This is insight. He understood his purpose. Many people walk in life without understanding their purpose. How I pray that you may understand your purpose. How I pray that you may have an insight to understand who you are. When you understand your insight, then you will pursue the purposes of God. You will pursue what is important and not temporal. Because many people pursue the things of the world that are very temporal and they leave them here. Praise God. But Paul said, oh hallelujah, that you understand my insight into the mystery of Christ. So it is very important. Even in Matthew 13, it talks about the keys of the kingdom and the secrets of the kingdom. The secrets of the kingdom is to see with your inner eyes. Hallelujah. When you see with your inner eyes, you understand that you are temporary in this world. And you understand the things of God are very important in your life. And you understand the destiny that God has for you. And you understand that God has a purpose and a good plan for you. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. And you are able to pursue the things of God. And you are able to see yourself not as people see you. Not as your history sees you. You are able to go through your hindsight and it will inform your insight. And then you can see the foresight. You can see what is ahead. Praise God. Oh, hallelujah. So number two, before I go to number three, is you need to understand, have an insight. So we say number one, you get what to know the grace of God. That abounding grace of God that is available for you. The grace of God to be what God created you to be. That grace of God that wants to extend you to your boundaries. Hallelujah. When I look into my life, when I look at hindsight, I can see what I used to be when I go to secondary school, even a day school, cooking for myself with no hope. And I see what God has done in my life. He took me to campus. He gave me so many jobs. He made me to travel around. He opened so many opportunities for me. That is hindsight. Praise God. And now I can see my insight. That informs me that now God has a good plan for me and he was preparing for me. And then I can see what is ahead of me. Praise God. I can see what is ahead of this church. I see a big church full of people. Praise God. I see so many people being delivered. I see families being restored. I see many leaders being brought up. I see so many churches being brought up from this church.
in the name of Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah.
This is foresight. This is what we see. And this is what keeps us moving, praise God. And we are able to break the limits. Number three, the last one before I finish, is you have to break the limits.
Hallelujah.
For you to occupy your territory that God has given you, there are limits, there are boundaries. The work of the enemy is to shrink your boundaries. But the word of God says you have to break the limits. Isaiah 20:10, 12 to 13, it talks about the king of Assyria. And the king of Assyria here defeats the enemy, the devil. And the Bible says in chapter verse 12 to 13, the king of Assyria removed the boundaries of nation and plundered their treasures. The work of the king of Assyria was to remove the boundaries of the people of Israel and to take away their treasures and put them into slavery. That is the work of the devil. John 10:10, he comes to kill, loot, and destroy. Hallelujah. So the enemy comes to kill. That is why so many people with potential, the enemy has shrinked their boundaries. People who could have been great, they've been shrinked. People who are thinking because of drunkenness and other immoralities, they've been shrinked. Their boundaries have been shrinked. We come against that in the name of Jesus. And today we have to break the limit. Praise God. Even Abraham, the Bible says in Genesis 15 verse 4, even God was talking to him greatness. And he was telling him, you'll be a great man. Abraham was arguing with God and saying, it is not possible. I have no children. But the Bible says in verse 5, God took him outside. He took him out of the tent because he was listening somewhere in a tent. God had to take him out of the familiar and God take him to an open place so that he can see. Hallelujah. How I pray today that God will open your eyes and he'll take you from your familiar. You know, some people say, this is the way I was brought. This is the way we are. This is the way we live. We pray that in the name of Jesus because God has a good plan for us. He took him outside and showed him the stars and told him, can you look? Because in the tent was so limited. And he looked outside and he could see. Hallelujah. Micah 2:13. As we finish, the Bible says what? The breaker, that is the Messiah, will go before them. They will break through, pass through the gate and go through it. And their king will pass on before them, the Lord at their head. I want to declare you that Jesus is the limit breaker. We break every limit right now. I break every limit in your life right now. If you say that you can never drive, I break that in Jesus' name. If some people say, I cannot be educated, I cannot go to this level, my children cannot go to this, I cannot be like this because my teacher say this. I break that limit in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter. Oh, hallelujah. If you believe in Jesus, he's a limit breaker. And that's why in Micah 2:13, he says the breaker, the Messiah will go before you. I declare today that Jesus is going before you right now. He's breaking every link right now. Every limitation in your life. He's leading you to your divine boundaries. He's extending you to your boundaries. If you have one business, I declare that God can extend you to more businesses. It can even become an industry in the name of Jesus. He is the limit breaker. Nothing should limit you. Hallelujah. Jesus took away every written code, anything that was written for us, and he canceled it. Colossians 2:14. He has broken every written code. Kila kitu ilikuwa imeandikwa juu yako na wazazi cha zamani na wazazi wa wazazi wetu wakasema hamtaenea. Jesus alikuja akaivunja. Kama umeokoka uko na Yesu ndani yako, amevunja kila nila. Praise God. He has broken every limit. He has broken every curse. He has broken you and he has set you free to be what he wants you to be. He has taken away and given us the victory. Oh, praise Jesus. Leviticus 26:13. As I finish, I am the Lord your God who brought you forth out of the land of Egypt, that you should be no more slaves, and I have broken the bars of the yoke. Jesus has broken every yoke. Yokes of sin and immorality, they are broken in the name of Jesus. He has set us free. He breaks every yoke. He is a yoke breaker. He is a limit breaker. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He is the name above every other name. There is no one like him. Oh, we worship him this day. He breaks every yoke. He sets us free. He can take your family even where you never thought it's possible. He can take you even in your academics where you never thought it's possible. You can even go even to that level of PhD in Jesus' name. He can set you free if you are bound by sin and immorality. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Oh, Psalms 24:7 verse 8. Lift up your hands. Psalms 24:7 verse 8 to 8. Lift up your hands, your heads, you gates, be lifted up. You ancient doors, that is the King of glory, King Jesus may come in. Oh, this day we decree in the name of Jesus. All those gates, all those things, even ancient doors, even generational limitations, generational yokes, generational bondages, generational sicknesses and diseases, we break them in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible says in Psalms 24, lift up your hands, all you gates. We lift them right now. We break every limitation. We break every limitation in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in the battle. King Jesus is the Lord mighty in battle. He's able. Hallelujah. He's more than able. He break every yoke. Break every limitation. You can be what he wants you to be. You will live into your divine purposes. Wewe utaingia hatima yako ile Mungu alikuwa amepanga. Katika jina la Yesu. He loves you. He cares for you. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise God. He is there. And he is there for us to break every yoke. So as we finish, summary, we've talked about three things. That the Lord, how do we occupy these boundaries that we saw in Acts 17:26? From one man he created all men, and he gave them a time that they may have dominion. And he gave them boundaries, divine boundaries. He has given us a time. How do we protect? Number one, we need to allow the administration of God's grace in us, in our lives. And we looked at Corinthians, praise God, 7:8. Hallelujah, 8:9. And then number two, we said about getting an insight of our divine boundaries. They are divine boundaries that God has given us. We get an insight. We get our inner eyes to see. Praise God. That is why Jesus healed so many people in their eyes. And he's talked about spiritual blindness. And number three, that we need to break the limits, the limitations. Hallelujah. I want us to stand as we pray over these 3 points in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to break every yoke. We want to break and set our people free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Just stand up. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Just lift up your hands. We thank you, Father. We thank you for the boundaries. Oh, yes, Lord, according to this topic. Acts 17:26. You created us from Adam. Oh, God, and you gave us the times. And you gave us a ranch to reign. Kila mtu umempatia boundaries. Umetupatia mipaka. Umetupatia familia. Umetupatia maeneo. Umetupatia huduma. Kuna zile vitu umepanga katika maisha yetu. Watoto wetu kuna mahali umaelekeza. Mahali watakuwa na wataonekana Bwana. Utawabariki, utawainua. Hata nchi yetu ya Kenya Bwana. Ni asante kwa sababu ya maeneo. Thank you for the divine boundaries. We receive them right now. We speak right now. The academic areas that you are extending us, oh God, we receive right now. Oh, Father. Oh, we open our eyes, Lord. We open to the grace of God. The administration of the grace of God is working right now. To my brother and my sister right now, I speak the abundance of the grace of God. Neema ya Mungu katika jina la Yesu. Saving grace for them who want to be born again. For them who are oppressed of the enemy, we speak sanctifying grace in the name of Jesus. For them who are backsliding, oh Father, sanctification grace is what we pray right now. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it right now in the name of Jesus. I speak the grace of speed in the name of Jesus. Fruitfulness, increase, prosperity, security and protection. Even during this area of COVID-19, I speak the grace of protection in the name of Jesus. For you and your children, in the name of Jesus. We receive, Lord, the administration every day of the grace of God. Every morning we wake up, oh Lord, we will thank you for the grace of the day. Oh Father, we will not take it for granted. The administration of the grace of God. Even to reach unto people, oh God, we thank you for the grace working in us, oh Lord. Number two, we thank you for the insight, Lord. Open our inner eyes, Lord. Open our inner eyes that we have an insight of who we are, of the potential and the seed of greatness that you've put in us, that we may see the riches of your goodness, oh God. That, Lord, you are looking unto us to be partners with your work, oh God. Open our eyes, Lord. Oh, in the name of Jesus, I come against the blindness of our people. In the name of Jesus, that they cannot see the goodness of God. They cannot see what God wants to do in their lives. I break the yokes of the enemy. I break the chains of blindness in the name of Jesus. I set the people of God free. Even for those who are watching us, Lord, right now. I pray from the top of their head to their feet. You open their eyes. They may see the grace of God. Oh, and the potential that is in them. And the work in the church of Jesus Christ. Oh, we pray for insight, Lord. In the name of Jesus. And lastly, Lord, we break the doors. We break the limitations. We break the limitations. Any limitations in our academics, limitations in our families, limitations in our generations, we break them right now. Whatever the enemies have set, even in our forefathers, generational limitations, we cancel them right now. We cancel them right now. In the name of Jesus, we break every yoke. Oh, Jesus, we lift our hands, oh Lord, Psalms 24, verse 7, oh, verse 8, and we say, oh, you ancient doors, you generational limitations, you generational yokes, generational sicknesses and diseases, we come against you. We refuse. You will not have a place in our hearts. In the name of Jesus, all the yokes of COVID-19 that is oppressing the church and the nation of Kenya, we come against you now. We break your power. We break your hold to put the church of Jesus Christ down. We cancel you and we negate you in the name of Jesus. Oh, we break every yoke. We break every chain. Oh, chains of smoking and drunkenness. Our people who are not born again. In the name of Jesus, we break the yokes. We break the chains. We release the people of God free. Holy Spirit, our comforter, our teacher. Oh, may you comfort us. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Just give a big hand to the Lord. Hallelujah. We worship you. Just worship him a bit as we finish. We worship you. Just worship him. Open your mouth and worship him. We thank you, Father. We thank you for breaking the yokes. We thank you for abounding grace of God. We thank you, Father, for the insight. I want to see, Lord. I want to see the purposes of my life. I want to live this life, Lord, to the full and maximum. I want to be what God you wanted me to be. I refuse any blindness. I refuse any fear. I refuse any, oh God, ignorance of not using the grace of God that has been given unto me. Oh God, it is my desire. Whoever will listen to this message, oh God, in the name of Jesus, they will live to their purpose. They will live to their destiny. In the name of Jesus, I protect their destinies, oh God. And I cut the chains and the powers and the yokes of the enemy. And the spirit of fear and bondages of sin. In Jesus' name, set them free by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's give a big hand to the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we worship you. We thank you for your word. And everybody say amen. Amen. Say, I receive it. Amen. Say, that is my word. I break the remits. I have insight. And I have administration of the grace of God. And I extend to my divine boundaries. In the name of Jesus. May God bless you. I love you so much. Amen, amen. That's the word of the Lord today.